Hi, Sirdar here from InfoWorld at IDG. Today in SmartPython, we're going to look at Python's bytecode caching system, which is generated from programs that you run and helps make them run a little faster. When you write a program in Python and you feed it to the Python runtime, it isn't run as is. It's first converted into what's called bytecode, a series of instructions used by the Python runtime. Python code is easier for humans to read, but bytecode is easier for the machine to read and work with. So we write in Python, and we have the Python runtime convert to bytecode to make the job easier for everyone involved. In an earlier video, which I've linked below, I mentioned using the DIS module to show how bytecode instructions compare to their readable Python counterparts. Now, because the conversion process can sometimes take some time, Python will often save a copy of the converted bytecode as a file alongside the original. So on future runs of the same script, it will just read back in the bytecode rather than reconverting it every single time. The bytecode is stored in a binary format using the file extension .pyc, and it's kept in a subdirectory of the directory where the source code lives. This subdirectory is called pycache, with double underscores before and after. Each of the cache files in the pycache directory is named after the original file, with an identifier that indicates what version of Python it's used with. The cache files we see here are for CPython, the standard Python runtime, version 3.8. If we run this program with a different edition of Python, it's going to generate new cache files for that version. Now, PyC files are functionally interchangeable with Py files. In other words, I can replace any Py file with its PyC equivalent, and it will behave exactly the same way. It just won't be readily editable. It'll also only be possible to run the PyC file on the version of Python that it was originally generated with. So if I generated PyCs from version 3.8, they will only run on version 3.8. Now, sometimes you'll find that cache files aren't generated for some scripts. For instance, in this project, the conway.py file has no corresponding bytecode file in the cache directory. That's because Python has a quirk where it typically doesn't generate bytecode files for whatever is the entry point in an application. And this is to avoid the overhead of creating bytecode files for something that we're just going to run maybe once so that we're not cluttering up the application directory with it. Conway and ConwayCython are run directly, and so there's no bytecode generated for them. But they both import this module timer, and so we have a bytecode cache for timer, since it will probably be reused repeatedly on future runs. Now, we can also instruct the Python runtime to not create bytecode at all. If we use the -b flag when running a script, we don't generate any PyC files for that run. This is useful if you want to ensure that no cache is ever created for a particular script and that you're always using the human-readable source version as your actual code. Now, what should you do with cache files? The short answer is generally you don't do anything with them. You should just leave them alone. If a given cache file is out of date compared to its source code, Python will detect this situation and will regenerate the cache file automatically. Also note that you should never place anything else manually in a PyCache folder. They should be considered read-only by you. One other thing you should do is exclude cache directories from any Git or source control systems that you're using for your Python project. There's no point in committing them since they just get regenerated anyway, and they add unneeded noise and overhead to a project's repository. If you're using Git, you can use a line like this in your gitignore to ignore all of the cache directories in a project. Now, if you're a bit obsessive compulsive like me and you'd like to perform cleanups on an entire project directory and get rid of all of the PyCache subdirectories in one swoop, you can do this. You can recursively clean out PyC files in the directories from your repo just to get a fresh start. Here's an example of a PowerShell script that will do that. You run this from the top of your project directory and it'll clean out every PyCache subfolder. The only downside, of course, is that the next time you run your application, those things all have to be regenerated. That's it for this episode. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Smart Python, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.